1991, the Northeast has seen one of the greatest increases in annual precipitation nationally. The number of days containing heavy precipitation events has also increased by 58% from 1958 to 2007. Future climate predictions strongly indicate that both annual precipitation and heavy precipitation events will continue to increase over the next 80 years. This suggests that commercial growers who produce fragile crops, such as berries and small fruits, will need to adopt farming methods that help to reduce the risk of crop loss. One way commercial strawberry growers can protect their crop from precipitation and other inclement weather events is to incorporate a barrier between plants and the environment, such as a small tunnel called a low tunnel. There are a number of materials that can be used to build low tunnels. Some of these materials are engineered specifically for low tunnel production systems and are available commercially. Most low tunnel systems have four basic components: hoops, plastic to cover the low tunnel hoops, a tie-down material to secure the plastic to the low tunnel frame, and an anchor object for the ends of rows. Hoops are inserted into the ground with one leg on each side of the bed to create a low tunnel frame approximately 2 to 3 feet above plants. Hoops can be made of wire, metal conduit, PVC piping, or a thick gauge galvanized steel sourced from a low tunnel manufacturer. Wire can be purchased pre-cut or in coils, and because it is often the go-to in vegetable production in the Northeast, it may already be on hand on many farms. However, it is important to pay attention to the gauge of the wire, as thicker gauge wires will be more durable. The length of the low tunnel material is also an important consideration, as this will determine the height of the tunnel and the width of the plastic needed. Each end of the low tunnel hoop should be inserted at least 1 foot into the ground to ensure long-term stability. Therefore, we recommend a 10-foot long wire or conduit piece for an 8-foot wide plastic. On the other hand, PVC piping is not typically inserted into the ground and is instead placed over a piece of rebar that has been hammered into the ground. Therefore, the length of PVC should be about the same as the width of the plastic being used. While it is tempting to space hoops apart as far as possible to reduce the number of hoops needed, a closer hoop spacing ensures plastic remains on the tunnel frame and does not slide off during strong wind or storms. We are recommending a 5-foot distance between low tunnel hoops. After the low tunnel hoops are in place, the plastic film can be placed over the low tunnel frame. Some plastics may need to be cut to the correct width for low tunnels, but commercial low tunnel films that are about 8 feet wide are available, and it may also be possible to special order films from your supplier. If possible, plastic should be unrolled directly over the frame. Take caution not to drag the film across any rocks or objects on the ground during installation, as small perforations in the film can and will split once there is substantial tension on the plastic. Plastic can be obtained in a number of thicknesses and perforation levels, but we have found that thinner films that are approximately 1 to 2 mil thick are the most user-friendly, both at installation and throughout the course of the season. The primary advantage of thin film is that the sides typically remain raised and vented when the plastic is manually lifted. Thicker films tend to slide down and often require they be rolled up in segments to remain vented. This makes raising and lowering sides more labor-intensive and time-consuming. Once the plastic film is covering the low tunnel frame, attach the plastic to an anchor object at the ends of rows. We recommend using hollow steel pipes that are approximately 1 1/4 inches wide by 24 inches long. These are easy to install and remove, but stay in place all season. U-channel posts or T-posts have also worked well in some locations, but wooden tomato stakes, even treated ones, should be avoided as they tend to break as the season progresses. Long pieces of rebar have not worked in our experience and are not likely to be sufficient. It may also be helpful to install a small tensioner or ratchet between the plastic and the anchor object to remove slack lengthwise in the plastic as it stretches throughout the season. We have found that parachute cord works excellent for this purpose. pull as much slack as possible out of the plastic during this stage of installation. Zip ties are excellent for quickly attaching the plastic to the anchor object at the ends of rows. Finally, plastic needs to be secured to the low tunnel frame using a tie-down material. Polypropylene twine or bungee elastics both work well for this. The tie-down material can either crisscross between hoops and run the length of the tunnel or be attached at each hoop individually. It is also necessary to have something to attach the tie-down material to at each hoop. Some commercial low tunnel systems, such as the Dubois Tunnel Flex system, come with a small peg at the base of hoops for attaching the tie-down material. For other hoops, another object can be added to the system. For wire hoops, polyethylene piping or a semi-rigid rubber pipe can be cut into small pieces and a hole drilled perpendicular through the tubing. This piping is then slid onto the bottom of the hoop. Be sure the piping is snug on the hoop and stays in place. Rebar hooks inserted into the ground at the base of hoops are another good option. The most important low tunnel installation step is tight installation of the tie-down material. A very tight tie-down material removes remaining slack in the plastic that was not removed lengthwise and keeps the plastic taut. This prevents water accumulation on the top of tunnels, and it prevents plastic from sliding off the tunnels onto one side. A good rule of thumb is that each hoop should look like a small wave. Grounding stakes, either rebar hooks or stakes sold as a component of a commercial low tunnel system, are good for ensuring low tunnels remain in the ground during windy weather, which on a rare occasion can pull hoops out of the ground if not secured. While low tunnels do require labor to lower and raise sides before and after precipitation, a thoughtfully and well-installed low tunnel system is unlikely to have any major problems and serves as an insurance policy of sorts for your crop. We suggest purchasing quality parts and finding a combination of materials that works for your operation. For more tips on ensuring a successful low tunnel installation, download our free low tunnel management guide linked below.